I'm a dating coach, and my company is called Love Hacks. And so, yeah, we're going to talk about dating. Dating for nerds. Yeah, I help men in the age of 30, 40, or and also 20s to find and to find and conquer the love of their lives. I've been doing this for 4 years now, full time, and so that is my business. And I really like it. I have been interested in dating since my 12th, I think, and in men and women and gender and how the game works and what does work and what doesn't. Come over. And it's been really exciting. And then I began to study psychology at the UvA in Amsterdam, and did my master thesis on dating. So I'm also a scientific dating coach, because science. But science, I thought, also was a bit too theoretical. It's like looking into the lab to see what population does what behavior, you know, as a social psychologist. And I thought it was not really suitable for practice. I wanted to have more experience in practice, so I already dated a lot, but it's still my biggest hobby. I love to date, and I also think I'm pretty good at it. And the story of my life has been always like, what to do with my life? And then a couple of years ago, I discovered, what is my biggest talent? What am I better at than anybody else? And to my surprise, I figured out, well, I'm really, really, really good in finding amazing relationships in my life. I always have the most awesome partners, and I love these guys to bits. And then I felt like, well, what kind of profession can I do with that? You know, what can you do with that talent that's only handy, like, for your personal life, but professionally, I don't know. But then I thought, like, hey, maybe I should help people with that, because there's a lot of people that struggle with finding relationships and flirting, dating, and it's not always that easy. Also not for me. It's not easy, but it's so much fun. So I tried to share that enthusiasm with the people around me. So there you have it. And why men, may someone ask? I wanted to help men because there's a lot of... what do you think of when you hear the word dating coach? What kind of people are they? Dating coaches? Yeah. No, I was wondering, like, what association do you have with a dating typical dating coach?
They need to be open and communicative, because they probably solve the made connections by looking into the souls of people.
So ooh.
otherwise, you can never find a good relationship for someone else.
All right, pretty close. Yeah, well, my association with the word dating coach is that they're all men. Like, there's a lot of men helping other men. It's a very masculine, yeah.
And that's wrong word.
Hmm?
I think a woman should help.
Yeah. Exactly, exactly. So now, in the Netherlands, there's a lot of men helping men. It's a very macho world. And then I thought, hey, but I could, like, add something new to that. Like, because, as you said. So that's why I chose this to help men. And I love men. Men are my favorite people in the world. And almost all of my friends are men. And I think men are very cool. All right. So now you know why you're here. Who of you are single? Oh, pretty much. Cool. Thanks. What do you find hard about dating, flirting, love? What is, yeah, what is tough, you know? Can I ask you?
Well, I absolutely love the theory behind it, but I'm mostly a theorist, but to bring stuff into practice is a bit difficult for me.
Mm-hmm.
On the other side, I'm a very open person, so
mm-hmm.
it helps a lot.
Yeah, so you know a lot of theory, but the practice is...
I can't set myself to really go beyond the theory kind of setting.
Uh-huh. So, you find it hard to go come out your comfort zone, or?
Probably.
Yeah? Okay, let me write that down. All right, just to inventorize. What else? Who dares to share a problem, a frustration?
Well, I sincerely apologize, but I'm in a very happy relationship. And was
great! Good for you! That's what I mean. Bye! that's why I it's good that to introduce myself. All right, so who else? Who dares to share a common frustration?
Well, if you go with theory, then you can also say that meeting girls is technically a problem for us.
Lead generation.
Yeah. Lead generation. That's a good one. I'm very happy that you say that because I was going to talk about that. Thanks. So, maybe who thinks it's hard? Who knows how to flirt? Who thinks it's hard to flirt with someone that you like? Flirting, or is flirting covered? Yeah, flirting in theory is easy, but well, to set to make the step and to say, "Hi, I am fabulous."
Mhm.
Mhm. Yeah, great. Well, that's good. That's good. And how about? All right. Awesome, good for you. Good for you.
Yeah,
thanks. Yeah. And it's fine to leave, eh? If you're just like, okay, this is not for me, I'm in the wrong spot. Yeah. Yes, you feel free to leave. Also, you don't have to ask if you can go to the toilet. That's fine. All right.
Think it's incriminating to be here if they're in a relationship or what?
What?
The people think it's incriminating to be here.
Well, it's very personal. Sometimes if you're in a relationship, it's like, well, yeah, I love to learn about flirting. It all sounds awesome, and that you can flirt anytime. My opinion about flirting is to you can do that with whomever, wherever. If you're in a relationship, if you're not in a relationship, flirting is one of the biggest misunderstandings about flirting is that you can only do that when you're single and with a person of the gender you prefer, and then also that they have relationship potential, and then you can flirt. And I think that's bullshit, because you can flirt with whomever, and I can very much recommend that. So flirt with the elderly, flirt with the kids, flirt with men, with women, and definitely flirt with pets, because they're awesome beings to flirt with, especially with cats. You know, who flirts with cats sometimes? They're so flirty. They're like, they just stay just out of reach, and then you have to be really seductive, and they maybe come to your way, and then they give like one little touch, and they go like, and then they walk away again, like very coy, very like flirty, like very hard to get. And it's flirting with cats is the best. And it's actually to practice on those beings, and also with like other people than what you find interesting for your love life, it's a great practice. And to observe their behaviors, like how do they react to my flirting, is brilliant. So I can very much recommend that. Okay, I think the lead generation is really interesting. Yeah, because with lead generation, you mean where do I find these people?
The only place we see is our couch, our bed, and work.
Sometimes a convention like this, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Thanks. I'm going to talk about that today. So, good for you.
Well, where do you then go? You have like a bar, but they don't know how cybersecurity works.
Mm-hmm.
They probably use Facebook and stuff.
Yeah. Okay. So, you got options is a what you can.
Too lost in translation.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. So, like a bar or a party. Or Facebook.
Not that far.
Yeah, these are like should I do this? Should I do this? Should I do this? So these are like the ones that we come up with now. Or what about dating sites? It's also very logical. Or dating sites is also a very logical first thing that you think about. Like, should I maybe be on a dating site or stuff like that, right? Okay, so a lot of people think like, I would like to have a special someone in my life. Where to look? And the first weddings. good one. Any other obvious places?
Work. Not good.
Exactly. Work. Okay, so these are all of the obvious, or a lot of people also say the supermarket. So that is some of the obvious things you hear. Like maybe friends could advise that. Maybe you say to them like, hey, yeah, I'm having a bit of trouble with flirting, and where do I find the right people for me? Where do I find them? And your friends say, why don't you go to a bar? Why don't you just go to Facebook? Why don't you just go to a wedding? Why isn't there a special someone at your work? Maybe that secretary over there? And no, try again. You know, she's great. And those are like pretty lame advices. Even dating sites can be pretty lame, because maybe you already tried that. Maybe it's like, yeah, but it's just won't work. And for some people, it does. For some people, it's like super smooth with dating sites, and it's amazing. For some people, it doesn't. Now, why is that? Why is this advice also so obvious, but so like, yeah, but no? Well, because these places are all pretty random and big. These are like big pools of thousands of people. For dating sites, for example, like Tinder, these are lots of people, and in this big pile of people, it's really hard to find the right one for you. To find, you always like encounter the same kind of people, like the girls in the yoga poses, and another girl in a yoga pose. Well, how about that? Or another person on an amazing travel location with the Machu Picchu pyramids, you know? Well, what to say to those people? And on the other hand, if you're on a dating site, it's also like incredibly hard to stand out from all the other guys with the six packs and the super slender girls and the really good looking ones. It's really hard to stand out if you're just average, like me. And So that's hard. So these are like big pools. So it is good if you want to do start your lead generation by choosing smaller pools. Smaller pools. So here's a small pool. Not such a big pool. So there are a couple of people in it. Not too much, not thousands. Maybe 100, maybe 50, maybe 25. Right? Some interesting people, some men, some women. I wouldn't go to a pool with only men. if you're a guy and if you're looking for a woman. And if you're a woman, I wouldn't go to a place with only women. So if you're a woman, you won't have much success on another yoga school or other girly things. so make it like mixed. You can do it the other way around. If you're a guy, go to yoga school. That would be fun. Okay, so what to look for when you're looking into this new, like you wanna how do I say this in English? Een nieuwe groep mensen aanboren, zeg maar. Where do you find this new special group of people where there are so many folks that would love to meet you, like really love to meet you? It's always good to go to a place where they would love to meet you, you know? Instead of go to a place and where you feel you need to chase these people, you need to try really hard to meet them, you know? It's like, oh, it's so much easier when you let them come to you. And that's you can totally make that work for you. So, how to do that? So, inderdaad, look for small pools. Not the big ones like Facebook or yeah, work. what else? Let me think. Yeah, so there's four or three or four, I don't remember, randvoorwaarden. I don't know what's that in English. Sort of, what? Prerequisites, yeah, thank you, for those small pools. Like, hey, where are my people at? Where are my people at? Make sure that it's new, that it's new to you. Because there's a beautiful quote, and it sounds like, if you always done what you always did, you get what you always gotten. So, and I really love that one. It's harder to explore new territories in your life. Like it's harder because you don't know if you'd like it, and it's hard to get out of the house with something that you are like, I don't know anyone there. You know, like you know that going to a birthday where you don't know anyone is always like, I don't know if I'm up to this. That's a good feeling, like that feeling, follow it, because, yeah. That brings me to point two, make sure that it feels a little bit uncomfortable, that it feels a bit exciting. No, not necessarily, no.
No, just mean uncomfortable and exciting.
Yeah, because something can be new, like a new supermarket, but you will just like, oh, there's a new supermarket, whatever. It's not really exciting. So make sure that it's a bit like exciting. Not terrifying. What?
Can you give an example?
Sure, yeah. For example, if you'd always wanted to learn how to fly in a small airplane, but you don't know where to start, and you don't know which airport to go to where they provide lessons, you don't know which instructor to call, to contact, it can feel a bit scary, you know? It's like, I don't know if I can do that. I don't know if I have to have money for flying lessons. I don't know if I will like it. I'm a bit afraid of flying, you know? Like, a bit scary, but exciting. Don't make it too terrifying, because you will crash and burn. If you think like, I'll never do that. So if it's a bit exciting to you, follow that feeling. Yeah? So exciting. And there's another beautiful quote, and it's very cliche, I know, but the magic does happen outside of your comfort zone. It is true. It is true. So make it a bit exciting. There's a like this. So here's the fun pool. Fun pool. And this is your comfort zone. So you need to take the dive, the leap of faith. Yeah, and that can feel hard. Something feels hard every time. But it's the feeling you need to follow. It's like, do it, you know? So, yeah, that'll be fun. Okay, three. And this is so the obvious, but I'm going to mention it anyway. Make sure that it's social. Lots of people here. Yeah? There's also a point four, but are there any questions so far? So clear? Yeah.
So you said small pool, but now you're saying social.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That was like,
yeah, absolutely. They're like, it's big pools are like thousands of people. Smaller pools are like 100, 50, 25, but make sure it's social. Like it's not like two people. That's okay. Too small. Yeah? All right. Point four is, and this is very important, make sure it's absolute fun. This is a very important one. Go to places that really excite you. Also in the spannende manier, like that it's exciting, but also that it's really fun, that you're having a blast while you're there. A lot of the times you don't know that because these places are new, right? But you're gonna find out if it's fun to you, if you go there and you're like, this is so much fun, I never knew that. Keep on that way. Stay on that way. You told me, Reiner, you told me the story that you went to play, you'd never been there. Could you tell me what you discovered there when you came there for the first time?
That's for me, it's really enjoyable because it's a really cool and open group of people.
Mm-hmm.
It's different than, for example, going to a loud bar, or it's also a group of people that doesn't drink or doesn't drink much.
Like alcohol.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they party together.
Yeah.
Yay. Yeah. And you really like that was like a warm bath to you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Awesome. So if you're feeling that you landed in that warm bath, stay with that feeling. It's like, hey, I'm going to go again next week. And the week after that, and whenever they're organizing stuff, I will be there because I was having so much fun the first time. So follow that. This is a very important one because if you have like a lot of fun, you feel like right at home in that particular place, you radiate that. You radiate that like pure pleasure. And when you like walk around and in this new place, and you're like, hey, yeah, how are you? Yeah, you. People want to connect to that. People want to talk to you when they have questions or to like belong to you. Okay, he obviously know what's up. You know, he's having fun, so I should stick with this guy. Yeah, so that's very important. Absolutely make it fun. To become magnetic. Any questions so far? Okay. So these are, yeah?
Just a side note, that's follow those people and ask where to, which other events they are going to go.
With which people?
A nice way to figure out similar events that will also have the right feeling for you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like which people exactly?
Play has a sister organization called Eigen Tijdse Jongeren, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know if there's much overlap with, for example, the Sunday assemblies. But
mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. So, like, once you're there, ask around. Like, hey, what else is fun in this scene, right?
Yeah.
All right. Cool. That's a great tip, actually. Okay, so these are the prerequisites. Once you're there on a super fun place, a super new place, you're having a good time, you're meeting some new people, you overcome the first little hurdles, and it's kind of social. You're making new friends a little bit, you're meeting new people. Then what? Because you're not there yet, like that people will, like, you know. There's some great ways to become this magnetic person so that people will chase you. People's like, oh, this is an interesting guy. I want to know more of him. Once you're there, or you've been around a couple of times. This is beautiful. I'll switch my paper. Ask yourself, what can I give to this place? Wat kan ik bijdragen? How can I contribute? How can I contribute to this place? Okay, before I think I forgot something. Before I'm going to talk about contribution, I will give you some examples of places where you can, like, be right at home. It can be lessons, like if you always wanted to learn something new. Hey, always wanted to play the guitar, always wanted to learn this or that language. I always wanted to learn how to fly, or I always wanted to learn how to, well, whatever you want to learn, new skills, you can go on a cursus, on a course. My absolute favorite places, for me personally, is festivals. I'd love to go to festivals because there's, like, festivals on any theme imaginable, like music, or I go to a lot of hippie festivals because I'm a big tree-hugging hippie. Festivals are so much fun because the people who are there are, like, they have a very open attitude. They go there because they want to meet new people. So everybody's really open. And if you talk to them, they're like, yeah, what's your story? Tell me more. You know, they're like, phew. And I love that about festivals. So that's a good idea. You can also think about physical places, like maybe there's a really nice place or a comedy cafe if you like comedy, or a board game cafe if you like to play board games, and connect with those people. You can find a lot of these events, and this is maybe you heard of it on meetup.com. Like, all the events in the whole world, people organize themselves on meetup.com, and they just post events there, and you can freely subscribe to whatever event you want to go to. If it's like language, or hiking together, or playing board games together, or learning a new language together, or just hang out at the bar, or make music together, you can all find those on meetup.com, and there's definitely one in your neighborhood that strikes your fancy. So go there and just scroll around a little bit, and you will definitely find something that's interesting to you. So you can like discover a lot of like great new things on there. So yeah, you can also organize yourself events there. If there's your ideal event is not on there, you can organize something yourself, and then people will come to you, and that is really perfect because you want to attract people. But I will come back to that later. Let me go to how to you can contribute. All right, so. If you're at this exciting new place, think about how you can contribute. How can you make these people happy? And it can be really simple. And it can also you can also make yourself hard, you know. But if you want to start with something, just think about how can I give these people something small. And have you seen like? 10 years ago, there was this series on TV, super exciting. It was called Dexter, and he was a serial killer. Have you seen it? No? Okay, some of you do, some of you didn't. And Dexter always came to the office with a box of donuts. And he was like, hey, do you want a donut? Do you want a donut? And everybody loved the guy. Everybody was like, it was just an alibi to appear innocent, because he was a serial killer and he didn't want the police station that he worked in to find out. So he brought a box of donuts, and everybody loved the guy, and everybody was like, hey, Dexter, how you doing? He was everybody's favorite colleague. And you might think it's manipulation, but I think it's a beautiful way to make friends. And so it can be as small as, handing out like really nice pastry.
You're saying, come to the dark side, we have cookies.
Yes! Yeah, or whatever side you want to have them at. Come, we got cookies. So, absolutely, cookies.
Cookies on the internet don't count.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. But you can also think of, how can I contribute to this place? Maybe they need volunteers in the place that you love to go. Hey, how can I support your organization? Maybe you'll volunteer for a couple of bar shifts, or you can, if you got a fancy photo camera, you can offer to make pictures or shoot pictures of the event. Or maybe you can help them with their website, and the organization really loves when you offer those things. Like, thank you, you come just in time. So you can and think of what you got in abundance. If you got a certain skill that you're really good at, and you see like, hey, this event or this place is missing something in that direction, I can help out with that. Just offer it, and they will love you forever. And then that's definitely an amazing way to contribute. So people will definitely come to you if you are in that attitude. My personal favorite is I always come with a basket of mandarijntjes, clementines, tangerines. Yeah, I always come with a little basket of tangerines, and for some reason people always love tangerines. So I always got like people gather around me. It's like, oh yeah, give me the tangerines. So that's a really cute way of contributing. There's also a sort of contribution next level. So if you're like kind of you blend into the place and you're having a good time and you come there for a couple of times and you really found your new people. What you can do then, and this is the next step, is become a leader in that place. Leadership. In this conference, Hacker Hotel, there's always some people that are really visible. They're the people who organize this, who who moderate this, and like that everybody comes to with questions. Like there are some really busy people that like oh, I have a question, and they're like ah, so everybody comes to them, and they're really visible. So if you this is the next level of contribution. If you wanna be really visible, make sure you maneuver yourself in a position of leadership, and that is harder than a basket of tangerines. But it is so rewarding. It is so rewarding. Positions of leadership can be, well, not only organizing or moderating, but also like standing on a stage or giving a lecture or organizing a workshop. That's also a position of leadership. You become visible, and it's exciting, but it does pay off so much. In 10 years ago, in a previous life, I organized chiptune parties. Do you know what chiptunes is? Like 8-bit music and stuff. And my party was called Eindbaas. And we sold out like stage after stage. It was a big success. And I was literally standing as a chiptune DJ on stage. Like, so I was like literally very visible. Like, it was absolutely amazing, and the crowd was going wild, and everyone like took their shirt off and crowd surfing, and it was the best time ever. And I found so many love interests there. It was they found me actually. They like always walked up and was like, "I love your party, you're amazing," and it's like, okay, I just doing my hobby. So it is kind of scary, but I think that also the introverts amongst us can bring something and can really contribute something that they have an abundance of. And just make yourself visible. So that's a really key word here, visibility.
So what advice would you give to people who don't want to be visible?
the introverts, right?
Yeah, or don't enjoy being in crowds.
Oh yeah, that's a great question. Thank you. A couple of things. Select your a pool, like what I draw on the other sheets. Select your pool according to that. There's like great, amazing places for more introverted people. There's beautiful places for even for HSP, high sensitive person, like that they're like just have a lot of prickles. that really get tired of a lot of impulses. So it's like, I need a quiet environment, please. There's a lot of amazing places for introverted people, for HSP people. Like play is a good environment that you talked about. It's a really nice quiet place. You can go to meditation courses, like low energy places. There's amazing spots for that. Also, if you don't want to be like, I'm presenting this, you know, there's so much there's so much leadership positions you can take behind the scenes or behind achter de schermen.
Give you visibility, right?
It kind of does, because people will know that that you're organizing this. It's not like you don't like, hey, here's me, you know, look at me, but they will know that you organize it, and they will look for you out of themselves if they have a question. So you don't have to, you just can like sit in the sit between the curtains, and all people they will find you. For some people, I'm going to say something that is like Vloeken in de Kerk, and I think that's I just got a book about privacy on the internet, like online privacy, and how can you protect and guard your data. And I really love to be visible on social media. And I know that a lot of people are like, no, that is evil. I know it. But to me, it's a great way to promote whatever I'm promoting, like my parties that was Eindbaas, but also what I'm doing right now, like my dating coaching thing. And people just keep on sending me emails, and they know where to find me. So that's a way. It's not necessary, but it's like definitely a great idea. But so in whatever scene you end up in whatever pool, try to become visible there. And you can do it without social media, but you can like very, very definitely be visible within those groups. So this is a very, very important thing. Any questions so far? This is actually that wraps it up. Where to find your new amazing group of people, which will know where to find you, so you don't have to chase people. Aren't there any questions about this? I got so much more to tell. But I'm just don't. I need a start. I just don't know where to start at the moment. So yeah, this is how you. You don't need any dating sites for this.
I gotta go set up a workshop.
All right. Good luck with it. Bye.
Where can people find you?
Oh, thank you. Where am I visible? That is lovehex.com. Nee, not.com, .nl. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, lovehex.nl. And if you want to have, I got like this workbook with all these little exercises, these little flirt exercises, like that get you out of your comfort zone and that you can do wherever, whenever. So if you walk on the streets, you can do these little exercises to make small contacts with people. And it's called the Comfort Zone Challenge. And these are 28 small exercises. And they start very easy. You walk over the street, try to make eye contact with 3 people. Okay, so that's doable, right? But they build up. And the most difficult exercise, the number 28, is walk into a cafe and make a talk with the most beautiful person there. Like go straight up to him or her and just start a chat. And that's the most difficult one. Like, and okay, everything in between that is like all these little exercises you can do daily. And it's been fun. I did them all. And it's hilarious. So if you're interested in receiving the Comfort Zone Challenge, it's a little ebook. Just let me know. And I would lovely to send it to you. Yeah. Just come over to me and I'll note your email address. And all right. Well, are any questions so far? Then that's it. That this was my lecture about love hacks. Ta-da!